Here are the numbers. You look at the one on the left, it's hospitalizations is down at 13. The number continues to stay down for us. You can see the graph. We've kind of plateaued in this kind of area. 18 is the
7-day running average. But remember, the last time we were at 18, it didn't take us but 3 weeks to rise all the way from the bottom of the yellow area up to the red zone, which is why we have to be careful, even when the numbers are low. And then we're going to be talking about that in a little bit. 59 new cases today. That takes our 7-day running average down to 72. Same thing. The numbers are coming down. But remember that these numbers don't necessarily predict the future. We have to keep holding on to what we're doing. 6.2 in the bottom left-hand corner is the positivity in the community generally. We know that the Latino population is double digits, over 10. We've got to pull the entire community together so that we don't have infection, so that we have a better chance of keeping schools open and being able to open up businesses. Let's go to the next dashboard, and we'll do the green mint-colored numbers on the second dashboard. Also, you can find on the city's website. You can see that we have 125 people in the hospital today. The 7-day running average is 142. So the number is continuing to drop down. The 7-day average will continue to drop down too. 44 people tonight in the intensive care units in our city. 7-day running average is 52. It drops down. Folks on ventilators, 29 tonight, 32 is the 7-day running average. It's also coming down. You can see we have 388 people that have passed away. That's an increase of 3 over yesterday, which means we have 3 families that today are mourning in our city the passing of a loved one. We're continuing to head down. We've plateaued a little bit. But we saw yesterday from the University of Texas some indications that we're having a lot more movement than we have had in the past. And that's what gives us concern.